How now, Lucilius? Is Cassius near?
He has a tandem, Pindarus, has come to do you salutation from his master.
He greets me well. Your master, Pindarus, by his own chamber, by some ill offices, have given me cause to wish things done undone. But if he be at hand, I shall be satisfied.
I do not doubt whether my noble master will appear, such as he is, full of regard and honor.
He has not doubted. A word, Lucilius. How he received you, let me be resolved.
With kindness and with respect enough, but not with such familiar instances, nor with such friendly confidence as he hath used of old.
Thou hast described a hot friend's cooling. Ever know, Lucilius, when love begins to sicken, and decay useth an enforced ceremony. There are no tricks in plain and simple faith, but hollow men, like horses hot at hand, make gallant show of their mettle and their promise. But they should endure the bloody spur, they, like deceitful jades, sink in their trial. Comes his army on?
They mean this knight and Sardis to be quartered. The greater part, or worse in general, are fond of Cassius.
Hark! He has arrived. March gently on to meet him.
Stand home!
Give the word! Ho and stand!
Stand!
Stand.
Stand. Most noble brother, you have done me wrong.
Judge me, you gods. Wrong I my enemies. Now should I wrong my brother?
Brutus, this sober form of yours hides wrongs, and when you do them!
Cassius, be constant. I know you well. It does not do us well to argue before the eyes of both our armies here. Let us not. Wrangle, go into my tent, and you shall enlarge your griefs, and I shall give you audience.
Pindarus! Bid our commanders lead their charges off a little from this ground.
Lucilius! Do you like, and let not a man enter till we have done our conference. Let Lucius and Titinius guard the doors.
That you have done me wrong doth appear in this. You have condemned and noted Lucius Pella for taking bribes here of the Sardians, were in my letters praying on his side because I knew the man were slighted off.
You wrong yourself to write in such a case.
In such a time as this, it is not meet every knight's offense should bear his comment.
Cassius, you yourself are much condemned to have an itching palm to sell and mark your offices to gold for underservers.
Aye, an itching palm. You know that you are Brutus that speaks this. Oh, by the god, this speech rolls your laugh.
The name of Cassius honors this corruption, and chastisement doth ever hide his head.
Chastisement?
Remember March! The Ides of March, remember! We cannot do these for justice sake. What villain did stab and did not stab for justice? Show one of us that struck the foremost man in all the world, but for supporting robbers. Let our fingers be contented, and sell and grasp our large honors, for as much trash as may be grasped by this. I'd rather be a dog and bane the moon than be such a Roman.
Brutus, bait not me, I'll not endure it. You forget yourself to hedge me in. I am a soldier, I older in practice, abler than yourself to make conditions.
Don't you, you are not.
I am.
I say you are not.
Urge me no more, I shall forget myself. Have mind upon your help, tempt me no farther.
Away, slight man.
Is it possible?
Hear me, for I will speak. Must I give way and room to your master power? Shall I be frighted when a madman stares?
Oh, ye gods, ye gods! Must I endure all this?
All this, aye, more. Fret till your proud heart break. Go, show your slaves how power go, and make your bondsmen tremble. You have wronged me, Pius.
I denied you not.
You did.
I did not. He was but a fool that brought my answer. Now Brutus hath arrived in my heart. A friend should bear his friend's infirmities, but Brutus makes mine greater than they are.
I do not until you practice them on me.
You love me not.
I do not love your faults.
Friendly eye could never see such faults.
A flatterer's would not, though they appear as huge as high Olympus.
Come, Antony, young Octavius, come, revenge yourself alone on Cassius, for Cassius is the weary of the world. Hated by the one he loves, braved by his brother Chet, like a bond in all his faults observed, and send a notebook and learn, and con my ropes to cast into my teeth. Oh, I could read my spirit from mine eyes, there's my dagger! Here, my naked breast within a heart, dearer than Pluto's mine, richer than gold. If that thou beest a Roman, take it forth, I can deny thee gold, though give my heart strife as thou didst! Him worse thou lovest him, better than ever thou lovest Cassius!
Sheath thy paper. Be angry when you will, it shall have scope. Dishonor shall be humor. Oh, Cassius, you are yoked with a lamb that bears anger's flint, carries fire, who, much imposed, shows sparks and strays cold again.
How Cassius lived you with mirth and laughter to his brutus, when grief and blood ill-tempered have vexed him!
When I spoke that I was ill-tempered too.
You grieved that so much? Give me your hand.
And my heart too.
Brutus?
Oh, Cassius.
You're not love enough to bear with me when that rash humor which my mother gave me makes me forget.
I will. And when you are henceforth our earnest, dear Brutus, I should think your mother chides you and leave it be.
Let me go in to see the generals. There is some grudge between them, tis not me. There's you alone. You shall not come to that.
Nothing but death shall stay.
Come now, what's the matter?
Love and be friends, as two such men should be. For I see more years, I'm sure, than ye.
How now, saucy fellow, give place, sirrah, hence.
Away, away, be gone.
What should the worst do with these jiggling fools?
Come yourselves along and bring Masala with you immediately to us.
Lucius, a bowl of wine.
I did not think you could have been so angry.
Oh, Cassius, I'm vexed with many griefs.
Of your philosophy, you make no use in you can place the accidental evils.
No man bears sorrow better. Portia is dead.
Oh. Portia?
She is dead.
How escaped I killing when I crossed you? Insupportable and touching loss upon what sickness.
Impatient of my absence and in grief that young Octavius and Mark Antony have made themselves so struck with that her tidings of death came, and lest she fell distracted in her attendant's absence, she swallowed fire. Even so.
You will God!
And this I bury on
Lucius, so the wine o'erspilled the cup. I cannot drink too much of Brutus' love.
Come in, Masala, and welcome, good Venus. Get ye close about this table here, and calm question our necessities.
Portia, art thou gone?
No, no, I pray, Masala. I have received letters that young Octavius and Mark Antony are come upon us with a mighty power, bending their expedition towards Philippi.
Myself have letters in the selfsame tenor.
With what addition?
That by prescription of bills about Lari, Octavius, Antony, and Lepidus have put to death 100 senators.
Therein our letters do not well agree, might speak of 70 senators that have died. By that prescription, among which number, Cicero marks.
Cicero won?
Aye, Cicero is dead, and by that order of prescription. Had you your letters from your wife, my lord?
No, Masala.
Nor nothing in your letters read of her?
Nothing, Masala.
Now he thinks it strange.
Why, here are the friends, yes?
No, my lord.
Now, as you are a Roman, tell me true.
Then, like a Roman, bear the truth I tell. For certain she is dead, and by strange manner.
Why? Farewell, Portia. We must stand, Sally, with meditating that she must die once before I have the patience to endure it now.
Even so great men, great losses should endure.
I have as much of this in art as you, but yet my nature could not bear it so.
Well, let's do our work alive. What think you of bending our expedition towards Philippi, Felix?
I do not think it good.
Your reason?
This is it. 'Tis better that the enemy seek us. So shall he waste his means, weary his soldiers, doing himself offense, whilst we, lying still, are full of defense, rest, and nimbleness.
Good reasons must of force give place to better. The people twixt Philippi and its ground do but stand in a forced affection, but they have grudged us contribution. The enemy, marching along by them shall make a fuller number up. And so come on refreshed, new added and encouraged. For much advantage shall we cut him off if we do face him at Philippi Fields, these people at our backs.
Hear me, good brother!
Under your pardon, you must know besides, we have tried the utmost of our friends, our legions, our brimful, our cause is right. The enemy increaseth by the day, we at the height are ready to decline. There is a tide in the affairs of men passages, which, taken at the blood, leads on to fortune, omitted. All the voyages of this life is bound to shallows and to misery. On such a bold sea are we now afloat, and we must take the current when it serves us or lose our ventures.
Then with your will, go on. We'll along ourselves and meet you presently at Philippi.
The depth of the night has crept upon this top, and nature must obey necessity, which we shall neglect for a little rest. There is no more to say.
No more. Good night. Early tomorrow will we rise.
good knights, and noble Cassius, good knight, and good colors.
Dear my brother, 'twas an ill beginning of this night. Never come such division between our souls, let it not, Brutus.
Everything is well.
Good night, my lord.
Good night, good brother.
Good night, Lord Brutus.
Farewell, everyone. Take him back out. Myself, hold up thy heavy hand and touch thy instrument to strain unto.
What of Varro and Claudius?
Call them about and have them sleeping cushions in my tent.
Varro and Claudius!
Well, speakest thou so drowsily? I blame thee not, thou art o'erwatched. Sirs, no have them sleeping cushions in my tent.
So please, you should stand and watch your pleasures.
I will not have it so. Lie down, sirs, and maybe I shall otherwise be taken from me. Sir, Lucius. This is the book I saw, so I put it in the pocket of my gown.
I was sure your lordship did not give it me.
Gentle knave, bear with me. I am much forgetful of things. And so, hold up the heavy instrument and touch the strings.
Hi, my lord. Please you.
It does. I trouble thee too much, but thou art willing.
It is my duty, sir.
Thou should not urge thy duty past thy might. I know young blood serves for a time to rest.
I have slept, my lord, already.
It was well done, and thou shalt sleep again. I will not hold thee long, boy. If I live, I shall be good to thee. This was a sleepy tune. Oh, murderous slumber. Wait till I let him wait upon my boy who plays the music. Gentle knave, good night. Would not be so poor to master wake him. If he does not, he will break his instrument. Well, set it aside, and gentle knave, good night. Is not the leaf turned down where I last left it reading? Here it is, I think. How ill this table burns. Ha! Who comes here? Art thou some monstrous apparition that shakes my eyes? Art thou some god, some angel, some devil? Speak to me what thou art.
Thy evil spirit, Brutus.
Why comest thou?
To tell thee thou shalt see me at Philippi.
What, then I shall see thee again?
Aye, at Philippi.
Then I shall see thee at Philippi. Know that it takes much thou vanished. Oh, ill spirit, I would have more in store of thee. Lucius, voice, sir, Lars, Claudio, awake!
The strings, my lord, are false!
He didn't think he saw his instruments. Lucius, awake!
My lord?
What drunk you so that thou cried out?
My lord, I do not know that I did cry.
Thou didst thou see anything?
No, my lord.
Get thee to bed again. Varro, Claudius, sirs, awake!
Lord?
Yes, my lord? What dreamt you that I so pressed out?
Did you, my lord?
Hi, you did! Saw anything?
No, my lord.
No,
saw nothing, lord.
Go commend to me, my brother Cassius, and bid him to send his armies to the times before, and I shall follow.
It shall be done.